Everton. I just went and made myself some more. Some more coffee. And now let's continue. And I get a feeling that's gonna be a trap. Ha! Jokes are new, I can fly over. Shit! Alright, you got me. Almost. Come on, that's it. Get your ass over here. Oh, we did? I didn't even notice that.
Alright, you're all ready to go now. Quick, get to safety!
Sorry, but have you seen our little boy? We're awfully worried about him.
Otherwise, he's fine.
Calm down, dear. We don't even know if he was taken here or not.
But... oh, my little Daisuke!
Oh, please calm down, lady.
Don't worry, he's safe and sound. Someone's looking after him now on Yashiori Island. I can show you where on the map. He's been worried about you. I bet he'll be relieved to see you.
You were the one who saved him?
Not exactly.
Thank you!
No, please, no. No need to thank me. It's my pleasure, really. It's just who I am. It's what I do.
Before
you go calling me a hero, let me ask you this. Wouldn't any other self-respecting guy who saw another person
please tell me they're already gone.
The exact same thing?
That'll be hilarious if they're already
really?
Gone.
Just one little compliment and it goes straight to his head.
These fakers
okay, they're still here.
Insatiable. They'll do anything for money. No one dares stand up to them for fear of what they might do.
Well, would they really do anything drastic?
No, actually, because one of the guys, the one with Oni horns on his head, has always shielded us so far.
Oh, I see.
Oh, in fact, his horns look just like the ones this guy...
At night, he would secretly bring us food and water. I don't understand what he was trying to do. Are you
so deep down, even though he acts all tough, he's actually a good guy.
Relative, I guess.
Oh. Dude.
Maybe there's something secretly troubling him. He seemed different from the rest of the gang. They seem like heartless crooks, but I'd say he comes across more like a confused child who made some poor choices.
That's one way to put it.
There are a few things he needs to straighten out in his head, and I'm here to point him in the right direction.
I'm glad to hear that. He's lucky to have family like you.
Aww.
Don't worry. He'll be in my trusty hands. I'll help him see the light. Anyway, you should scram. It's still not safe here.
Yes, thanks again. You've rescued our entire family. We are indebted to you.
There you go. That was adorable. Oh,
a child that made some poor choices. Anyway, let's get going. We still have time.
Anything else here? Oh, I see treasure! I see treasure! Give me the treasure. Lovely. Hmm? Okay, is there anything else? Nope. Nothing over there. Wait a minute, is the... I'm confused. Which path it was? Or maybe it's this one? Oh, I see. Oh, I see. Don't know what this takes us, but... Okay, now I get it. Never mind. Actually, now I know where we are. Okay, now that makes sense. The reason why you cannot do that as before. I've seen the treasure. Yeah, just in case. Here we go.
This is the place. The jig's up. Surrender while you can.
Not gonna happen, dude. Ha! Let me see. Oh, over here, give me that. Look out of it. Anything here? Nope.
See no more. Run with the force. There's more. There's more.
There's more.
I hear everything.
Strike is one.
How's this? Who wants some of this?
Right, get him. Get them all. Wait, why the hell do you still have the shiny?
So, a little secret. A long time ago, I picked up this rare paper charm. It's very precious to me.
How can you speak without moving your mouth?
Tear one piece, the other piece starts tearing too.
Newsflash, don't care about your cute little origami obsession.
Dude.
You better stay where you are and let me finish. Aren't you curious what the other piece is used for? I'll tell you, it's now the critical component of a mechanism, and when it gets torn, this place goes up in smoke. Yeah, the whole hideout is rigged with explosives and ready to blow.
Oh, crap.
You're gonna blow this whole place up?
Oh, don't worry about me. I made sure that I've got an escape route. The rest of you, though, you're gonna be buried deep among the rubble.
Bring
You've
it.
Had fun. Now it's goodbye. My paper charm. Where's my paper charm?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh shit.
For this?
Yes, that's it. But when did you?
I snatched it earlier to stop you from doing anything hasty.
Why you? Now you're going to betray me?
You're one to talk. What about burying everyone here? If you ask me, that sounds like you've already betrayed our agreement, no?
Just give it here!
You done talking now? Huh? You sure? Great. Because I'm done listening.
Holy shit. Oh. What did you... Don't just flush like that.
Great work, Takuya. You arrived in the nick of time. Stay away from me.
Wait, what?
Huh? I said stay away or I'll tear the paper charm.
Pardon?
Hey, oh, okay, okay, fine. Just calm down.
Sorry, he's not going to do it.
Just because I won't let him blow this place to bits doesn't mean that I won't do it myself. Unless you want to get buried, you should leave this place now. Take everyone here and get out.
You won't go through with it. If you were that cruel, then why bother protecting every person you've come across, huh?
I'm not here
That's
to
right.
reason with you.
Is it too dirty?
Go! Just get out of here! This sacrifice is mine to make. Mine alone! Why couldn't you just stay out of it?
No one needs to sacrifice themselves.
All right, then you tell me. What am I supposed to do? I've tarnished our Oni pride and abandoned our ancestors' oath. Only sacrifice can restore my pride now.
I chose this path so I could provide for my fellow Oni. I was ready to die from the very beginning. This is between us, Blue Oni. But you... If it wasn't for you, everything would have worked out perfectly.
They're here.
What exactly were you planning?
Away this time.
Oh, shit.
Hey, Tenryo Commission! I'm the one you're looking for! I did it! I'm behind everything! Arataki Ito is innocent! You're the ones in charge of detaining criminals in human society, right? I'm sure you can tell who the criminal is here!
Huh? It's like he's trying to reenact the fairy tale! Sacrificing himself for the Crimson Oni!
Yeah, that's just a random dude.
That's what he's talking about. It's me you've been looking for, and here I am! How are you ever gonna report back without capturing me?
Stop fooling around, Ito!
Listen, Takuya, sacrificing yourself won't solve anything. Your sacrifice can't protect me or your fellow Oni, and giving up your life isn't gonna make theirs any longer. Sacrificing yourself is one way to escape your fate, but the only one you'll be setting free is yourself. Listen to me. You wanna be the tough guy? Huh? Well, this is the coward's way out. Don't let your sacrifice stain our Oni pride. The Blue Oni have been scraping the bottom of the barrel all these years, so let's give them a new beginning. We've made mistakes, but we can make up for them. Fate hasn't been kind to the Oni? Well, then let's tear it up and start over. But before any of that can happen, you need to get yourself behind me and forget about all that self-sacrifice stuff. Now let's go, but we're not done talking about this. Takuya!
I don't think so. He's gonna break it, isn't he? Oh shit, no! The other guy is gonna do it! Crap! It is, it is. God damn it. Well, that's not good.
I'll take care of this.
Oh shit.
There are still people in danger. Go, help them.
What?
Hey, I got this.
Come on.
Okay, let's do this. Oh, fuck yeah.
Forget about me. Just go. It's what I deserve.
No way you deserve it, that idiot. Holy shit! Uh-oh. Okay, that is awesome. Also, I just want to point out the fact that the voice actor just... The voice actor who was playing Aki at the Haruki... Fuck. Is playing Ito. It's the same voice actor as Ryuji from Persona 5. And both of them have a character just running and saving everyone. Like, they can be idiots, but you can bet they're really loyal to their friends. I mean, come on, that's just fucking awesome. If I didn't know any better, it's like the universe saying that, yeah, this voice actor is gonna be awesome. At least I hope so. There's been too many stories about voice actors who turns out to be not awesome. Look, see? There he is! And once again, just like with Ryuji, with our little death fake out. We have a death fake out with our boy.
That's gonna hurt tomorrow.
God damn it.
The looks on your faces. I said we'd be okay, didn't I? I'm sure I'd be looking a whole lot sharper right now if it wasn't for that brutal bean attack of yours earlier.
How was your... Oh, look at the sass. Look at that stare.
Why?
Why would you do this for me?
Because he's a good boy.
I don't deserve this.
Because you don't deserve to die, dude.
We share the same blood, brother. Our parents and their parents before them never taught us that it was okay to abandon family in need. I just wish you'd come to find me sooner. If you knew about me all along, then you should have come and asked me for help. I never would have dreamed of turning you away.
Aww.
The blue Oni disappeared so that they wouldn't bring trouble to the crimson Oni. If I came to you for help, wouldn't that just undo everything the blue Oni have done?
Not to me. I've always respected the blue Oni for their sacrifice. Nothing they did was in vain. It's only because of them that we have survived to see today and built a world where Oni and humans can live side by side. Honestly, everything that I have now, I owe to the blue Oni. And let me tell you, the Inazuma of today wouldn't see you as a villain just because of the color of your horns.
You say all that, but in spite of everything, you're barely getting by.
That's just how I roll, man. You remember the pack, don't you? We're not supposed to suck up to the humans. We're supposed to earn their respect. Every member of the Arataki gangs had a tough time trying to fit in. Take Akira, for example. He snores like you wouldn't believe. Or Genta. He's got a serious temper problem. And Mamoru? Well, he's colorblind.
Oh, what?
Even Granny Oni. She got that name for taking me in as a kid. We're all rejects and outcasts in some way, but we don't care. You want to talk about pride? Well, in our gang, we're proud to welcome anyone who's been through adversity with open arms.
No.
But I...
Oh, just shut up and join us.
Don't worry. Join them. Our Taki gang's already a bunch of misfits. You really think you could cramp our style?
We've dealt with the Kairagi and the people they took captive. I assume the two of you are finished talking. Takia, based on the findings of our investigation, I hereby announce that you are officially under arrest for forceful seizure of people and property. Please do not attempt to resist. All stolen articles will be reclaimed. That means we'll be seizing all the goods you passed on to your kin.
No, please don't. Without those goods, they'll...
It's all right, Takuya. Those goods never belonged to us anyway. Don't worry. I'll help take care of your kin. Now that I know the situation, I'll personally make sure they never suffer again.
Might want to put your grand plans on hold there. You're under arrest too, for numerous assaults on the Tenryo Commission.
Oh, that's right. Dude, you also attacked them.
Yeah, I guess I forgot about that.
I got that meat
yet. No worries, I'll put my gang on the case. My boys will take good care of the Blue Oni.
Yeah, we've already arrested them.
God damn it.
Oh, right, yeah,
Come on, what was there? No, I left Tracker behind everyone. Oh my god.
I guess it's up to you then, Traveler. Could you be a pal and tell Granny Oni about the Blue Oni situation? Yeah, I know the drill. This isn't my first time. And it probably won't be my last.
As for you two,
you are a bunch of troublemakers.
When you knew full well they were in the wrong, means that the culpability extends to you too. But, given your unique circumstances, and in light of the complexity of this case, we won't press charges this time.
Thank you.
Sorry for the trouble.
Hey, wait! Unique circumstances? Are these guys like a big deal or something?
Nope, it's nothing like that. We are not a big deal. I mean, we just fought a giant dragon. We fought, another earth dragon, I think. We fought the Aydra. We fought the Aydra's wife. We fought the Shogun. We fought inside of the Shogun. That came out weird. We fought, oh yeah, that's right. We fought a giant robot. Then we fought a giant whale. You know, no big deal. Not at all.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Cool. Because I was going to say, you know, like, I'm kind of a big deal myself. You know?
Right.
All right, see you next time. Whenever that'll be.
Sure. Oh, my goodness. Look at those two. Aww. That's one way to put it. Nope, he's not. He's just a big goof. Hey dear Granny Yanni. So, funny story, yeah, a lot of stuff happened.
Yes, that does sound
like those two.
So, did they take Uncle Ito away?
Yeah.
Yes, they did. But don't be too upset, Daisuke. We will have the chance to see him again. He and his
Yeah, he's just in timeout.
But the fact remains that he still helped us.
Yeah, I knew it! Uncle Ito helped us, and he's awesome!
Now, don't get any ideas, Daisuke. Ito is a far cry from awesome.
That's right, he needs to cause a lot of trouble. That's why he's in timeout. So don't you worry.
I'd say he's like one of those little...
Once he's out of timeout, he's gonna come back and have fun with you.
Though he looks fierce on the outside, he has a kind heart. He's not a delinquent, but he'll never back down from a fight.
I don't really get it, but it sounds like a compliment. I can't wait for my next beetle fight with Uncle Ito.
You're just gonna have
Thank
to wait.
You, Granny, for taking care of our little boy. I hope that Ito and his friends will be released as quickly as possible.
Yes, you needn't worry. The officials in the Tenryo Commission will certainly exercise sound judgment.
It's time we started heading back. We'll be sure to visit again soon.
And off he goes.
I'm glad that everything was resolved in the end. Things were looking quite dire, but now the future looks bright. Wonderful, wonderful. As for the blue Oni, just leave them to me. If there's one thing an old granny like myself can do, it's caring for others.
Do you need our help?
No, no. Go on ahead. I'm sure you have other adventures beckoning. Besides, once Ito is released, he'll be here to help me. Oh, yes. And you know what? I think that's what makes him adorable. Wouldn't you agree?
That's one way to see it.
He does whatever he puts
his mind to.
He's sincere, brave, and determined. Back when I took him in, everyone thought I was most unusual indeed. They started calling me Granny Oni. But I've never been ashamed of this name. On the contrary, I'm quite proud of it. Because Ito is my pride and joy.
Aww. That's adorable.
A long, long time ago, in a village lost to time, there lived a crimson Oni and a blue Oni. They were the best of friends. The crimson Oni wanted to be friends with the humans, so the blue Oni played the role of the naughty kid. And then he left. After a long time, the crimson Oni was living happily with the humans, but in his heart, he wanted to bring the blue Oni back home. The crimson Oni didn't know where to find the blue Oni. His search took him up the highest mountains and across the widest rivers. He found many traces of the blue Oni, but the more he found, the clearer it became. The blue Oni was hiding on purpose. So just as the blue Oni had once done, the crimson Oni left him a letter.
Dear Owl, I've made lots of human friends now, and I want to have a big party for everyone. I want all my friends to be there. That means you too, Owl. If you don't want to meet me, you can just watch from a distance.
The blue Oni snuck back to the village and hid in the shadows. He saw the great feast and roaring fire, and longed to join in. But though his stomach rumbled, the blue Oni remembered the oath of old and kept his distance. Suddenly, he jumped. The crimson Oni was right behind him.
Aww.
Hey, you're finally back. Come on.
Aww.
I'll introduce you. It's time everyone met my best friend.
That's adorable. I like this. So there you go. Another story quest completed. That was freaking adorable. On to the next one.